Wonderland came out of a question. I used to live in a high-rise in New York City, and I have two sons. And in the high-rise, there was an elevator that was always broken. It never worked. Like for 10 years, it never worked. They always said they were going to fix it. Right. So my kids would always ask me, where does this elevator go? So eventually, one day I said, if you go down, it goes to Wonderland.
It certainly is a whole new take on Alice in Wonderland. We have Alice more as a grown-up, and she has a daughter, Ellie. So it's also the take on growing up and looking back, and then things, taking a twist again. You're going to see all the regular characters from Alice in Wonderland, your Cheshire Cat, March Hare, the White Rabbit, the Mad Hatter. Mad Hatter is a bit of a twist because Mad Hatter's a lady in this.
The old Mad Hatter has gone. The guy that we know, sort of fun-loving, still mad, but a bit more wacky and crazy, has gone. And there's a new power-hungry, crazy gal, Mad Hatter, who's ready to take over Wonderland. She's evil, and I love it.
Alice and her daughter are the reality. They're the real. When she comes down into Wonderland, she meets all these fantastic larger-than-life characters like the White Rabbit, the Queen of Hearts, etc., which are the iconic characters. But in our version, it allows us that little bit of extra freedom because we're talking to an adult to give a different take on it.
Alice, the mom, she was in a tough time of her life. Her career, she was not going anywhere, and her relationship wasn't great, and her being a mom wasn't going so well. And she couldn't write because she kind of lost the child within. But she was also losing her own child because of circumstance and tough times that people go through. And basically, her journey through Wonderland was a chance to both save her child and save her child.
Frank, I think, has got this great vibe throughout all his shows, which is because he's a pop guy, he's an R&B guy. He's written songs like Whitney Houston songs. And you can definitely hear that through the show. My Mad Hatter stuff is, Mad Hatter is so swing, it's swing and jazzy, and then you've got others which are like pop classics in there. And then you've got real musical theatre numbers. It's great, like he's really captured this thing about contemporary theatre, which is crazy. And so I find you can either get sort of one or the other, and he just gets every genre of music in there.
I cannot wait for people to see all the costumes. It's going to be quirky, it's going to be spectacular, it's going to be fun. And I think we all need a bit of fun, especially with things that are going on in the world at the moment. God help us all. We need a bit of escapism and a bit of fun.
It is familiar in terms of the characters, but not the story. So hopefully if we do our job, you'll be swept up in the story and root for the characters, and that would be great.